What if I told you that ejaculating more might actually reduce your risk for prostate cancer? Well, don't just take my word for it. Let's dive deep into the science behind this. I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and if you like my content, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my new videos. Why does this even matter? Well, prostate cancer affects 1 in 8 men during their lifetime. That is not a small number of people. If you look at my subscriber base, I have nearly 400,000 subscribers. Of them, 90% are men. And if you even go with a rate of 1 in 10, because not everyone is in the United States, where that number is 1 in 8, and some countries have a lower incidence of prostate cancer, you can estimate that at least 30,000 of the people who follow me or subscribe to me will develop prostate cancer. That's a large number of people. So yeah, if we can modify something in our own behavior that can help reduce prostate cancer risk, well, why not? Why would ejaculation have anything to do with prostate cancer? Well, for those of you who don't know, the prostate's primary function is to create a fluid that you secrete during ejaculation that actually nourishes and protects sperm. And so that fluid essentially builds up in the prostate in between ejaculations. There are a few theories as to why ejaculation may be correlated with prostate cancer or not having enough ejaculation. And the number one predominant theory is called the prostate stagnation hypothesis. And what that is that over time, if you're not releasing that fluid, you can get carcinogenic secretions or secretions that are concerning for cancer promotion. And that actually can then cause the development of prostate cancer. There are also some other theories that may be that when you're ejaculating more frequently, you may have lower psychological stress, which can also be correlated with developing cancers. And the last theory is that having normal rates of ejaculation or more frequent ejaculation allows for what we call a normal prostate microbiome and also normal function of the prostate cells in regards to zinc and citrate metabolism, which are important for prevention of prostate cancer. So at the end of the day, there are reasons why people thought this was an interesting question to study. And what did they actually do to study this? So there's a couple really interesting things. This study was actually a survey done of over 40,000 men in 1992, and they followed these men up until 2010. And why is this important? Well, prostate cancer is a really slow growing disease. And so what that means is that you have to follow people over greater than 10 years to really see if the thing that you're seeing 10 years prior actually made a difference on their development of prostate cancer. And so they took men and they had them answer a number of different questions. And one of them was about, on average, how many ejaculations did you have per month during these 10 years? And the 10 years were between ages of 20 to 29, 40 to 49, so on and so forth. And so people had to kind of think back and remember and estimate how often they were ejaculating during that decade of life. And these men were asked to take surveys every other month. They also asked them about their physical activity level, their weight, their smoking history, if they ate processed meat, tomato-based products, alpha linoleic acid, if they've ever used a multivitamin, if they had life stressors like divorce going on, and just a number of different questions. So they did try to control for all these factors in the final analysis to determine if ejaculation frequency was indeed correlated with a lower risk of prostate cancer. And one important thing that came out of the study is they actually saw what ejaculation frequency was in this large cohort of men over decades of life. And it was very common to see that ejaculation frequency decreased with age. So when they looked at men who had ejaculated at least 13 times per month between the decades of 20 to 29, about 57% of men said that they had ejaculated at least 13 times or greater. But that dropped down to about 32% at the age of 40 to 49. So then when they looked at all the data, they kind of categorized all these men into different categories. And those that ejaculated 0 to 3 times, there were very few men that fell into that category. So they didn't use that as their comparison. And so they then compared compared those who ejaculated 21 times or more to those who ejaculated 4 to 7 times per month. I mean, 21 times is a lot. That's like 5 or more times a week to ejaculate, right? That's a lot of time to ejaculate. And so by the time they looked at all this data, these men were on average about 59 years of age, and they saw that the men who ejaculated between the ages of 20 and 29 and 40 to 49 who ejaculated 21 times or more compared to those who ejaculated 4 to 7 times had a 20% less likelihood of getting a low risk prostate cancer. This wasn't true for high risk prostate cancer or more aggressive prostate cancers with metastasis, but certainly a low risk prostate cancer, they were 20% less likely to get this diagnosis. So the reason I brought this study up, the study was done in 2016, but the reason I wanted to talk about it today was because I just started seeing news articles posting about this paper again about 2 weeks ago. And so I said, you know what, let's talk about this, because all the articles just said ejaculate more often. So is that what you really should do? Well, I think you have to look at these studies critically. And this was a really well-designed study. They followed people for a long period of time. They had really an excellent team of researchers and statisticians, and they controlled for a lot of different factors that might also be causing a lower risk of prostate cancer. But you have to think about it. Those who are ejaculating 21 times or more every month are probably either a different type of person altogether than someone who's ejaculating 4 to 7 times. They might be more physically active or more physically fit, so they're having more intercourse more often. So I think the real question is, you know, should you start ejaculating more often based on the data of this study? Well, I would say that while this is a really well done study and they controlled for a lot of factors like physical activity, stress, food intake, carcinogens in food, lots of things like that, it's still not 100% sure or clear to me that we should be prescribing all men to ejaculate 21 times a month so that they don't get prostate cancer. I think it's an important question. I think that if you are ejaculating very often, I think that that's not a bad thing, and you can certainly continue to do that. And if you're holding back because you think it's bad for you, well, probably it's not bad for you and you can go ahead and ejaculate more often. But when I tell you, you have to do it to the detriment of your social life and physical functioning and everything else that you do normally during the course of a month, no, I don't think so. So I hope this is interesting to you all. I thought it was interesting, and so I wanted to share it with you guys. Thank you so much for watching. As always, take care of yourself because you're worth it.